Alrighty, so what I'm talking about here is now the conversion process. Apparently, when you have the word processor, and then you head from word processor, and then you go to the caliber to turn it into like an EPUB or Mobi or whatever, it doesn't always do it so great, because what it does is it takes the caliber code and puts it on each line and then ends that line. And so when you switch it over into the Kindle, it gets that jagged upset. So wherever you left the end tail of your indent or your end tail of your sentence, it ends up dropping the words wrong. So for each screen size is doesn't work. So you have to take it from that program. You have to take it from the Kindle. I mean, it's from the caliber. So once you get it out of there to go to the PDF, you go to the caliber. Oh my God! And then you go to Sigil, S-I-G-I-L. Well, this is on my system. You know, this is a maybe somebody has a better way, but go to the Sigil, and then you can use all of the editors. And the editor on Sigil is a very good one. It is kind of WYSIWYG. It does have a Nisbet problem, that little spacer. It has also the span problem. It keeps bringing spans in, and spans are not helping the all sizes, you know, to fit all size screens. So spans have to be eliminated. And the Nisbets have to be eliminated. So you have to remove those. So it's not a fun process. So one book can take me at least 1 or 2 days just trying to convert it. So and then the images, all the images have to be modified also. And when I say modified, right now I'm just doing with the widths, and hopefully the widths are gonna hold up. That's like one of the worst things we have right now is this size issue with images. If you have an image size that is 300 by 400, and it has to stay that way, well, on a little tiny screen it doesn't really work, and so it's better to say you only want 70% of the screen. So if we could make images work that way, 70% of the screen up to a screen that is a certain specific size, and anything over that, it disqualifies. Then it would have to. So we have to kind of figure out some kind of way to make the images not continue. So if I get a screen size that is 17 inches and it's a Kindle book, it's not going to be 70% of that screen. It would have a cutoff. It would have a cutoff moment. So you say, okay, we get to like the standard 1200 pixels maximum or something, for even that's too much for these Kindle books. So if you know, bring it back down to 800 or something. So once you reach that 70% of your image, because it's much easier to modify images that way, if they're 70 or 50 or 100%, it's much easier for editing. So once you get to this maximum point, we're talking 800, and then it would not have an expansion module. It would not expand any further. It would say no longer can it go 70%. It has to take the 70% and halt it. So somewhere along the way, we're going to have to have some kind of a halt or a reversal code that says shrink rather. You know, shrink rather than expand. So you would actually get your 17-inch screen, so your little 70% where it was at 70% on and up to 800 pixels would be smaller on the 17-inch screen, because that's the only way to keep to keep it from being resolution ridiculous, you know, just looking stupid. So somewhere along the line there has to be a cutoff where it's going to reverse, where it will turn opposite from its command. Because right now width equal command is great, but if these books, these Kindle book things or whatever, these interfaces people are using, you know, these massive computers also for their readers, it's no good for that, is it? So we've got to think about making these books compatible after a certain point, and somehow that's a code change. So how can once the screen width is deciphered somewhere along the line, once the screen width is deciphered to be so large, the people who are making these screen widths, the code has to be updated, to understand that no, it doesn't get 70% of that massive screen any longer. It's going to only get 70% of an 800 screen maximum. So yeah, so we're dealing with some terrible problems with images, and the fact that these digital books are supposed to fit everything. I don't think so. I don't think that's possible. I don't think that's humanly possible. The computer coder world goes too far. Just goes too far. You're supposed to fit a little tiny telephone, and then you're supposed to fit a 21-inch screen or a TV set that's a plasma. I mean, enough. I mean, there has to be a break. So yeah, I don't know. That's where I'm at right now. I just went with widths, and I, you know, if you guys are going to be stupid and want to watch it on a plasma screen that's 30 inches or 800 inches across, or, you know, then be stupid. How do we block it in a way? In a way, they have to almost be blocked from using those massive screens. I'm tired. Yeah. So the conversion process. Conversion process is not fun. You go from the caliber, and then you go to the sigil, and then you go from the sigil back to the caliber, because it doesn't. And then that has to be converted. It doesn't like the EPUBs very often. So you have to convert that into another, like the Mobi, or I believe it takes other ones also. And then from those conversions, then it finally gets accepted through the Amazon people. And so yay. Anyway, I gotta go back to work. I have two more books to process, I guess. Because yeah, I made them, but then I didn't realize they were chomped line for line, so I gotta go and fix it. Oh my gosh, yeah. So there.